Hey guys, it's me, it's Queen Arsette Haru, and thank you for joining me for another wonderful edition of Ask an Aquarius. If you gotta ask somebody, you may as well ask an Aquarius. So, today we're going to talk about what happens when an Aquarius has mostly air signs in their chart. So, if you're an Aquarius and you look at your chart and you see mostly air, which would be Aquarius, Gemini, Libra, if you see mostly that or all of that, then you are a very airy Aquarius. Now, this type of Aquarius, like the rest of us, is pretty eccentric. But the airy Aquarius is like more flighty. They got their head in the clouds. They're more spontaneous usually. They're more impulsive usually. They're usually more talkative. These are kinds of people who are not easy to pin down. These are kinds of people who really would do better in like freelance work, artists, any kind of job that gave them freedom, they would do better in, because this is a person who doesn't like being tied to a desk or being tied down all day. This is a person that does good in the field because they would like to be out and about and talking to people and moving around, you know? This is a very airy person. Air is good because air means intellect. So this is probably a smart person, but this is probably a very misunderstood person, because an Aquarius with a lot of air can often be kind of weird to other people because they're the insane genius. You know, they're the kind of person that is so smart and so creative and so innovative that other people don't know what the hell you're talking about. They have no idea what you're talking about, no idea what you're doing. Other Aquarius might get it, or the smart people might get it, but the average person, this individual is going to look like an insane genius. You know, the mad scientist kind of energy. Like, you know they're brilliant, but you don't know what the hell they're talking about. So that would be an airy Aquarius. That intellect, liking to talk a lot. Because a lot of Aquarius, period, like to talk a lot. But this Aquarius is really usually, like I said, airy in the mind. They're always in their brain. So they'll even jump to different subjects, which is common for Aquarius in general. But this particular kind of Aquarius will probably do it a lot more frequently. A lot of Aquarius are like that. I'm even like that. I try to curb it, but I can jump from topic to topic and back to the first topic. A lot of Aquarius do that. And this kind of person would definitely be that kind of person and would be able to keep all of that, you know, straight in their head. This is a really intelligent, like Albert Einstein kind of individual. Now, that's on the good side. If they're not on the positive side, this is going to be the kind of person who is an airhead. You know, they can't remember anything. They're always losing their stuff. You know, they're like an airhead. Just their head is in the cloud. Like, what are you thinking? They lose things all the time, this airy kind of person. And they never on time for anything either, because they don't have a good grasp on time, reality, the earth. You know, they're not with the rest of us on the earth. They're up in the stratosphere somewhere. And most Aquarius are like that to a certain extent anyway. And then you put all this air in the poor child chart, like what are they supposed to do? You know? And it depends on what kind of air it is. Is it more Aquarius air, a lot more Aquarius, because I have a lot of Aquarius in my chart. So is it a lot of Aquarius, or is it a lot of Libra, or is it a lot of Gemini, or is it a combination? That's going to say a lot, because if it's Aquarius with a lot of Aquarius, they're going to just be very textbook Aquarian. Textbook, like me, textbook Aquarian. There, whatever you read in the book, the majority of it is going to fit with this person, you know? And if it's more Libra or more of a mix, you'll get more. The Libra will bring more of the charm. The Libra will also bring more of the talkativeness and the socialization skills, because that type of person is going to like kissing babies and rubbing elbows and talking to people. So that will bring more of that. And if it's Gemini energy, it brings more of the writer, the writer, the talker, the thinker, the philosopher. It brings more of that. So it just depends on what kind of air it is. But either way, this person is usually really eccentric and really smart. And I mean, you can't say anything bad about being eccentric and smart. But if you're an airhead, then people will constantly be angry with you for forgetting things. And some of your smartness is going to be more book smarts than common sense. See, you know, if you're smart, you can be really book smart. You can be intelligent. You could know how to do calculus in your head. You know, you can be that kind of person, but lack common sense. Like, just, you know, just lack the basics, like putting two and two together, you know? And if you're a person who is airy, you could lack the common sense, but you could have the book intelligence, you know? So it really depends on how the elements fall into your chart. That's why I always tell you, if you really want to know about yourself, you have to get your own chart done. Somebody has to sit and do your chart and explain to you or type up what it's talking about in an interpretation. You know, that's how you really know you. Otherwise, again, you're just pretty much picking up generalizations, and they may, some of them, most of them may fall in an area that fits you, and then some of them may not fall in an area that fits you at all. Okay, so that's what happens with that type of energy. These people generally are loners too. I've noticed a lot of the air ones are loners. I think it's because they're always in their head and they're very entertaining to themselves and they're really smart and they're always, you know, doing something along, you know, doing something, always doing something. And these type of Aquarians also have a tendency to be into their humanitarian or their project or whatever kind of thing they're into, whatever their hobby is, whatever they're into it. If they're into cosplay, you know, whatever they're into, they're really into it. And my chart is mostly fire and air. So I have a lot of that kind of energy. If I'm into something, I'm really into it. Like, I have like 150 Oracle decks and like 300 and something tarot decks. Like, if I'm into it, I'm into it, you know? I'm always looking at Harry Potter theories, you know? I'm into My Little Pony, so I'm always, like, you know, watching the little cartoons, and I got the little plushies, you know? So if we're into something, we are into it, you know? All the way, you know? Reading, researching online, you know, that kind of thing. So that's the airy Aquarius. The more air you have, the more of that flighty kind of energy you're going to have. And it's not a bad thing. If you are somebody who is an airy Aquarius, what you have to do is things that ground you. You need to do grounding exercises. You need to work with crystals, hematite, black obsidian, onyx, you know, there's a whole bunch of them, other ones, you know, crystals that ground you, do meditations that are grounding, put your feet in the grass, you know, like these kind of grounding activities. If you have a lot of air, you got to bring yourself down. You got to bring yourself down to see what everybody else is doing, you know, and you're going to be in the air most of the time. But you want to bring yourself down sometimes so you can do a practical things, because this type of Aquarius may also have problems with just practical things like paying bills on time, you know, things like that, you know, practical things that have to do, mundane things, we would call them, doing the laundry, you know, cleaning up, those kind of things that are kind of mundane to this type of person. That grounding energy will help you to be able to be more in the world with the rest of us, you know, taking care of your bank account and saving money and doing those kind of things. This type of Aquarius may have problems with those types of things. So the more grounding you do, the better you're going to be in that particular area. Oh, it's time for us to get going, but I wanted to tell you guys something. When I was in Colombia the last time, I bought these gorgeous bracelets. They're a couple dollars. And I wanted to show them to you because I thought they were the cutest. So for any of you who are going on vacation in Cartagena, look out for these. They have all colors. I think this is turquoise and onyx, if I'm not mistaken. And I'm always trying to show you guys cool ways of incorporating crystals into your jewelry that nobody really knows. They just think it's ornaments, you know? So of course, I always use my pendants. This one is sodalite, and the sodalite is for my throat chakra to help me when speaking. And then I have these turquoise and the onyx. These are more protective stones. They have a lot of properties, but one of them I like is the protective energy. So check them out if you go to Cartagena. Okay? Thank you for being here, guys. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you know somebody who's dealing with this particular, natal chart placement, send them this video because they need to check that out, okay? If you would like to send me a gift or you want to send me a love donation, I will leave my PayPal and my information and my wish list underneath this video. If you want to get a reading done, gotta get a reading done, email me for an appointment. Let me see. And if you want to hit me up on social media, I'm there too. You can email me also if you have a question for Ask an Aquarius. And that's pretty much it. Thanks, guys. See you later.